Sippers, welcome to this episode of the Tea With Me podcast with me, Shane Todd. We have a guest episode today as per. Before we get into it, we got to give a big shout out to our sponsors. Kicking off with the Thompson's Brigade, the crew that make Punjana tea. Thompson's family been making tea in Belfast since when? Late 1800s, mate. Late 1800s. These guys absolutely love it. Everything about tea. They're mad for it. We've been to their plant. Is that, would you call it a plant? Their tea making plant?
Factory.
Their factory.
Facility.
Facility. We went to their facility and they facilitated us to taste some of their teas. And look, all I can say is we've peered in the bag of rival teas. We've had a look at them. We saw a bag being cut open. Multiple bags being cut open.
Two or three different bags.
Two or three. Dan and I sat. Look, here's the thing. Jamie from Thompson sat down in front of us, a plethora of bags, and he got out a knife and he cut open all these bags and he said, look at this stuff inside. And there was all sorts in there amongst the tea. There was twigs, there was bits of branch, there was what was her gravy. There was all this horrible stuff, and then he cut open his own bag and he showed us inside a bit of Punjana, inside a Punjana tea bag, and I swear to God, pure tea. And you can do that for yourself, do that at home. You won't, right? It'd be so weird if you did, but do inside that pure tea. Keep drinking Punjana, made in Belfast, Northern Ireland's number one selling tea. I'm actually drinking the signature blend range at the minute. They've got decaf, they've got all sorts. Enjoy yourselves, keep drinking Punjana. We're also sponsored by Manscaped. You gotta move into the 21st century when it comes to male grooming. Are you still using outdated, old, traditional ways to get rid of your pubic hair? You know, for example, are you getting your dad to tie a rope around his toe bar and then tying the other end of that rope around your pubes? And then asking your dad to reverse down the driveway? Stop doing that. The Lawnmower 4.0 is here. Manscaped, they had the Lawnmower 1.0. People said, what's coming next? They said, what about the 2.0? After the 2.0, people were flummoxed. Where can you go from here? Manscaped said 3.0. And what do they have after 3.0? It's only the fucking 4.0. This is the best in men's below the belt grooming. They have ball cleanser, ball deodorant, ball wipes. We're big fans of it here. We can't show you because we'll take it off YouTube, but we love it. For example, Mike here last week took 3 days off work to hire himself a glamping pod. Just him in Wales. He took himself over there and I said, what are you going to get up to? And he said, all I'm going to get up to is take care of myself down there. The man groomed for 3 days straight. And you had a great time, didn't you? Didn't eat. He fasted and he said it was like a ritual type thing. And look, he's standing over there with nothing on his bottom half and I can see myself in it. And I'm looking good. Manscaped.com, they have a million products, colognes. They have all different types of stuff. Go over there, have a look at what they have and use the code TWITHME for 20% off and free shipping. That is in the bio, the link and the code if you want it again. Keep supporting them, keep supporting the podcast. Patreon.com/TWITHMEPODCAST if you want to really help the podcast out. You in turn for that get a Monday bonus episode, you get a Friday live stream and loads of extra content. You can watch our last actual live podcast in the limelight. Only on Patreon at the minute with Kieran and Dave. That was a lot of fun. We're doing the live podcast again on the 10th of March with one of my guests today. I'm Mickey Bartlett. You can't come to that if you haven't already got a ticket. It's sold out. And that episode will go on to Patreon. We'll put the odd clip out there, but Patreon's where it lives. Patreon.com/TWITHMEPODCAST. I'll do 2 dates at the end because I need to get into conversation with this guy. My guest today, big friend of the podcast, been on the live stream since Pussy was a kitten. He is none other than William Thompson.
Hiya. Since Pussy was a kitten.
Yeah.
I love that saying.
Since Pussy was a kitten. I love you, mate.
Oh, thank you. I love you too.
Cheers. There was a bit of jeopardy there where I was like, I don't know if you're going to say it back.
I'll say it back.
I'm glad you did. Willie T. I don't know. Have you? It's been a long time since just we've been one-on-one doing an episode.
Yeah.
Even the old studio.
I never did the old studio. I only ever did in here.
Nope, you did the old studio.
Did I?
Yes.
Did I?
Because here's how I know, right? There's a... I think I'm right. I hope I'm right. You came in to do an episode in the old studio, but I think this was even before Tea With Me. This was when I was doing the Shane Talkcast.
I definitely didn't. I never did the Talkcast.
You did, and I'll find it. This, like, you're like a guy, what do you call him? Guy Pearce in Memento. Look at these two squirreling away into the research.
Yeah.
I did an episode with you, and it's called Daddy Pig, and the reason I know that is because in my car, for some reason, it's saved on my phone amongst all my music. So I'll be like sitting in my car vibing to like Freak Me by Another Level or Brandy Ray J, Another Day in Paradise or something. The best brother sister combo of all time. What?
You're just living One Wish.
Yeah. I'm listening to Lil Bow Wow, and all of a sudden,
let me hold you.
No, Bow Wow, Yippee Yo, Yippee Yay. And all of a sudden, it cuts into me asking you what you have for breakfast. That's how that podcast starts. Dan, can you confirm this for me?
Not yet.
Our fact checkers haven't found it.
Well, that's weird. The week that Russia invades Ukraine, Dan all of a sudden can't find things.
Dan's found the
insider. Insider. Yeah, we definitely did do that, but that was in the studio. But then
you forget stuff. Full brain damage, guys. So I don't remember shit. Do you know what I mean? I have to hide my material across a stage because I don't remember it. I just find pages.
But you can forget bad things, yeah?
Oh, oh yeah, 100%. That's good. 100%, yeah.
That's good.
Which,
what, you definitely can't find this?
You said that as if you were going to attack me. You'll forget bad things.
Episode 7 of Tea With Me, Daddy Pig.
Yeah.
This week I'm in isolation.
Did you just have a... did you just hallucinate me there?
Oh no, I think you've given me brain damage.
Is this like the end of Fight Club?
Oh man.
That's fucking amazing.
He's fucked me over. What do you want from your producer, a guy you've known for a few years? What do you want him to go, yeah mate, you did do that episode? That's all he has to say. Lie. But all of a sudden, fucking Ofcom over there. Actually, I think you'll find.
Actually, you were talking to William, you were just staring at a wall.
He's trying to whitewash history. That's what he's trying to do.
Because you remember and asking me what I have for breakfast. That is every time we meet each other. Yeah. What you have for breakfast? That's all we talk about. That's always the same answer.
I have porridge. The shittest chat in the world. Anyone I meet. So, what did you have?
What you have for breakfast? It's 9 o'clock at night.
Here's the thing. I have the same thing every day. So I like to hear the people have done other things.
Yeah.
But what did you, when you were at the age where you got to like pick your own breakfast, what were you going in with at the start? I could see you on very sugary cereals.
Not,
you know what I could see you do? You know the wee multi-pack
of
different cereals?
Yeah, like but I'm mixing them.
I think you would take a spoonful from each.
Yeah.
I could see you doing that.
I have done that. I've just, you know, got some Rice Krispies and Cocoa Pops. You're fucking them together.
Well, and that's a metaphor, hopefully, for race, you know?
Yeah.
Bring it all together. And
in a big bowl in the morning. But no, when I first got left alone in the house, when I was like 14, it was like Pop-Tarts. Do you know what I mean? Which now...
You didn't get left alone in the house. Until you were 14?
No, well, yeah. Not like they wouldn't have left the house, but like, you know what I mean, when my mom and dad weren't in, like,
you needed a constant chaperone until you were 14.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm pretty sure whenever I was 8, my dad went to Tenerife for a week.
I love how you weren't neglected, dickhead. Fuck you. You're watching Home Alone, man. Like, I don't see the problem with any of this. It'd be weird if he went with the family.
Also, how much did I as a kid probably look like Macaulay Culkin? But I just had to pretend I had like older brothers and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
I was just sad. Sad, lone guy. Yeah. Do you know, and this is 100% true, I used to do stand-up about this. I thought, so I didn't have a brother and sister until I was like 14 or so.
Yeah.
But I as a kid always described myself as a lonely child. I didn't know the phrase was only child, so I was beaten about school if teachers asked, oh, do you have any brothers or sisters?
I'm a lonely child.
Me, looking at Macaulay Culkin, I'm a lonely child. What did you have for breakfast, miss?
I had frosted treadies and Honey Nut Cheerios together. My dad left the milk low enough. He's away on holiday. You can reach it.
My daddy's waiting for adventure. He's bringing me back a Woody Woodpecker's head.
What do you mean a Woody Woodpecker?
We, you know, that's what they have in Fort Aventura. They love Woody Woodpecker.
Oh, that's like the mascot of the place?
Yeah.
I love. Remember Rock? Remember getting a big stick of Rock back from somewhere?
Yeah.
Soft Rock was really nice. You
meant, like, remember Rock? Remember Rock was the thing, bro?
They say it's dead, man, but I don't know.
Yeah. Sam Fender, bro.
Yeah. Remember, like, fucking Nickelback and...
Yeah, like, you cutting about with, like, a mod haircut, like you're one of the Gallaghers. See, if you could you could pull off a good Liam Gallagher for Halloween.
My, I could pull Liam Gallagher off for Halloween.
I would pull Liam Gallagher off with my mouth.
Would you suck, Liam...
Well, I'm not even letting you finish your sentence. Yes. Yes.
But
and it wouldn't even be gay.
But you think he'd be sly to you during it? Like, I don't think he'd just enjoy it.
I hope that's like a part of
you're
it.
You're a prick, mate, you alright?
Yeah.
And you're like, no, I'm just trying
that's
to.
Fucking you. Shit, hey, cunt. Yeah. I don't know why he's a Scouse. I can't do it.
I don't know what I did either, but I remember.
Worst Liam Gallagher impressions.
When I was like P5, someone got me a jumper from Next, and I didn't want to wear it because I was like, I just don't like this design. I don't think it works for me and my palette. And I remember my mum saying, Liam Gallagher designed this for Next. And I went, well, give me it. And I wore it religiously for about a year. And then in about 2012, my mum revealed a bombshell that was just a lie. There was no Liam Gallagher Next collab ever existed.
My parents used to always do that with me. Like, if trying to get you to eat your vegetables, and be like, you know, Stone Cold Steve Austin always eats his broccoli. And you're like, I'll grow up to look like him, man. All right. I love that when parents do it.
Wrestling was... I used to love wrestling.
Yeah. I still kind of... I'm kind of getting... off it now.
You said that like it's open. Like
I'm all for wrestling, bro.
You just get like, you're just doing like one WrestleMania a month.
Yeah.
That's it for withdrawal.
It's like, see when you've shit to do in the morning and you're going about and you're tired, you know, you've bags under your eyes, you haven't really eaten properly.
I haven't stayed up since 10:30 in 12 years.
Do you know what I mean? Because now they're long. They used to be like 2 hours long. Now they're like 5 hours long. They don't end at like 6 in the morning.
Right.
And then people are like, what's wrong with you? And as a grown man, it's hard to look someone in the eye and go, I was watching wrestling.
Yeah, especially me as a dad. Like, I can't, like, imagine I, like, forget to pick my son up, you know, or, like, let my son down in some way.
Yeah.
Oh, what were you doing? Oh, sorry, fucking...
Hell in a cell last night.
Didn't pick up a wee man till 7 p.m. from school, but, fucking... SummerSlam was on. I don't know. Is that a thing? I don't know.
Yeah, it's a thing, yeah.
I wanted to be a wrestler when I was younger. When I go, I thought I'd be really good at it.
So did I. But did you...
I don't think it's too late.
For me?
For both of us?
I mean, it's kind of... It was too late from the moment I was born. So...
But I think you could be... You could use having cerebral palsy as, like, your wrestling thing.
That's my gimmick.
Cerebral palsy. You know, you could... Yeah. Palsy could be your name.
Yeah.
You just go by the wrestling name, Palsy.
The name Palsy.
P-A-U-L-Z-Y.
I just sound like I'm from West Belfast then.
Yeah. No, it's a wee mafia thing. Hey, Palsy!
There was a guy who had one leg. Used to wrestle. He had like a fake leg and a real leg. And they wrote him off TV by having Brock Lesnar rip off his leg and beat him with it. So they're not the best to us disableds.
Yeah.
What was your wrestling? Did you have a wrestling name, a wrestling gimmick?
No, I just remember in school when you would like play wrestling like first and second year, I thought I was pretty good at it.
Yeah.
I thought I was pretty good at it. Also, like, I'd attempt some like quite high flying moves and I would never put my opponent in danger. I would say that to them during it. I go, listen, your safety's my paramount too.
I used to always be like, something doing a high flying move, I'm like, don't worry, I'll catch you.
Huh.
Never did.
No.
Didn't even try. I'd go, I'll catch you, and I'm like, oh fuck no, they look heavy, and just walk away.
Yeah.
Leave them face first.
Let me ask you this. I actually don't know if I know how you got into stand-up. Because we're talking about wanting to get into wrestling and that sort of thing. But you got into stand-up really young.
Mm.
What, like 17 you were doing stand-up?
17, and I would have done it.
I was 18, I hate that you were 17.
Oh, I know it bothers you and I love that. Do you know what I mean? It's not like you get people starting stand-up who are older than me. And I have like near a decade of experience. It's weird.
Oh yeah. Some people don't start till they're 40 or 50 or whatever.
Yeah. And I'm still a relative like young guy. And I'm being like, right bro, here's what you need to do.
I think that's great. Because of your age, and because you look young, people still in a way think, like, you haven't been doing it for that long.
Yeah.
But that's, and that's real good.
Yeah.
Because then you can just surprise him.
It's also, you mature, as you mature, like, I now filter my life through bits. Like, you know, every time something happens, I'm like, okay, I can do it. I know how to make this a bit.
Yeah, and I think that's good when something bad's happening.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah, or even something embarrassing's happening to you. You're going, oh, this is terrible, but at least I'll have 5 minutes out of it. At least I'll have 10 minutes out of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Something like that.
Absolutely.
Like, when I was getting circumcised, when they were cutting the last bit of foreskin off, like, I was in agony, but part of me's like, there's 7 minutes to be had here.
Yeah, yeah, 100%. But how did I get... I would have gotten into it earlier, too, if I thought I could.
Well, if you got into it at 17, only 3 years ago, you weren't allowed in your own house unsupervised.
I know. It's just like doing gigs, bro.
What was the first gig you ever did?
It was Lovers.
Oh, yeah. I knew. I remember you were very new to it and doing Lovers, but I didn't know that was your first.
My first ever gig was with Paddy McGackie, Geddes, and Chris Kent. And I just did a five. And you don't remember how I got into stand-up. You're the reason I got that gig. And you don't remember this story, right? You never do, because I bring it up to you. Because I used to do Facebook videos, and they were like, shit, you're like a 15-year-old with an iPhone in your house. But they, for some reason, did well.
Right.
Like, they would get good. Like, and I message you and be like, is there anywhere I could get a spot? And you said, just message Colin, say you'd like a five, and say I said to say to him. And you don't remember doing that.
That's quite mafia of me.
Yeah. Don't get it.
Yeah, there you go. I didn't know that.
Yeah. And you never seem to remember that.
That's really sound of me.
It was really sound of you. I know. That's why when everyone's like, Shane Todd's a fucking cunt, I'm like, no, he's not. When people are stopping me in the street and being he's a bastard, I'm like, no, he's not.
But then on the other side of that, don't be like, see, honestly, like, I was 17, I DM'd him and he helped me, you know, he was DMing me when I was 17, yeah. don't add that to it, just be like, oh, he's a nice guy.
Yeah, but yeah, no, yeah, it was me came to you, though,
yeah,
because I knew you did it.
Yeah, and say that again into that camera.
It was me came to him and then he came in me, so.
You made me sing Wonderwall for some reason. Yeah,
you were shaking a tambourine over my head.
Oh, I wasn't a tambourine. That's why I get circumcised.
But I was such a big fan of comedy here. Do you know what I mean? Like, from the Audio Picnic. I remember your first appearance on Audio Picnic.
I used to be... Like,
I can remember what you said on it.
On podcasts, especially back then, and if there was a lot of people on the podcast, I would always... It was difficult to, like, get your laughs in.
Yeah.
And then also you didn't want to sit there and say nothing. So I remember just being not funny.
Yeah, yeah.
What?
I know what you mean. No, exactly. I know what you're remembering that correctly.
Well, do you know what I have? So yesterday we were filming a sketch here. I have my first ever stand-up book.
Why does it look like it's been pulled from the fucking archives of World War II?
Well, it has, because I started stand-up in 1947. This is my first ever book. Of stand-up and, like, thoughts and notes and all that sort of thing.
That wouldn't even surprise me, by the way, if your first ever actual book was something you'd written. Like, the first one you've ever read. I wrote this.
This is the first book. This is the only book I've ever read. Do you want to hear the premise for a bit of when I was 18, probably 17, writing this and thinking, this is hilarious, people need to hear this? The way... bus drivers wave at each other in Belfast. I thought in my head, that's a premise for a bit. So how, like, Ulster bus drivers were always really enthusiastic wavers, but the Metro bus drivers were a bit harder and wouldn't really give it. But then they'd only give it to each other, but a Metro bus driver wouldn't give it to an Ulster bus driver, but an Ulster bus driver would give it to a Metro bus driver. I had a 5 minute bit about that, and then about how,
you
like...
You got 5 minutes out of that. I got
5 minutes out of that. 5 minutes out of it. But... seeing this, there's no punchline. There's nothing funny. It's all just like, that might be like pigeons in Belfast smoking.
That used to be me doing stand-up. I'm like, I'll make a premise out of that and then just go back to it. And you're like,
yeah.
What am I writing? I'm a madman.
I'll find some... right, here's a bit. People that when people used to go to school, the shorter your tie was when you were at school, the shorter your life expectancy. Do you know what I mean?
No.
Guys with cocktail sausage ties, all dead now. But if you had like a nice long tie, you're still going.
Do you know what? Yeah, that could work now.
None of this could work. None of it worked at the time.
If you worked on that, there's something there.
None of it worked at the time.
Because some the people with the shorter ties were the ones who had the mates who would just yank your tie, and that's why it's so short. And they're all rakers and dead.
I was writing one-liners that weren't like old traditional existing one-liners, not knowing you can't just put them into your set. I've been fucking doing like Paddy Irishman jokes here. Listen to this. I opened with this, right? Purely because back then as well, there's no social media. You can't, like, you could message me and be like, he does stand-up, let me ask him this.
Yeah.
You couldn't do that, so you didn't know.
Yeah. Your experience would be like reading a book or something on stand-up.
Two Irishmen sit in the ground, one falls off. I open with it. My first ever gig. Why am I still doing this?
These are the kind of jokes that people will stop me in the street and be like, I've one for
you. You'll love this. I wrote out my first ever 5 minute spot in Black Box. I wrote out a script and then had never learnt the script. So like 10 seconds into the gig, of course I forgot my train of thought.
Yeah.
And then I just spent my whole gig talking about how badly everything it was going.
That's horrendous.
But I think like you, I look young, even though I was young, looked young. So the audience loved that.
Yeah.
You know, they're like, feel sorry for you in a way.
Yeah. I'm at Joe, my first ever bit I wrote was ever. And I only stopped doing it last year. It was the parking spaces bit.
Oh, right,
No, it wasn't in the form that it's in.
Yeah,
but that
was
the first bit I
think
ever
sometimes
wrote.
You can definitely go back to older thoughts and go, I approached this totally the wrong way, but the premise, there's something in that.
I've
like,
never done that. Like,
never done
all
that.
My old premises are shit.
Yeah.
All terrible.
How different do you think you are now as a comedian to when you first started? Like, what are noticeable differences?
I'm not as dark.
Right.
I used to go dark for the sake of dark and deliberately talk about like what's in the news and what's topical and try to be really smart about it. And I'm like, no, I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm definitely more confident on stage. I'm a lot more friendly. I used to kind of want to be like Frankie Boyle.
Right.
Almost.
You wanted to be Scottish?
Yeah. Yeah. I want to be ginger. And
is he ginger?
Disabled people. Is he ginger? Is.
He's more autumnal, no?
He's like a fucking dyed honey monster. He's nothing but ginger hair.
All right.
He's like...
Maybe I'm colorblind.
He's like Jerry Halliwell's muff. Get Frankie Boyle up and show him his
that
ginger
That sounds
fuck.
Like such a like 2001 reference. You saw Jerry Halliwell's muff.
Yeah.
Do you write for
welcome
Nuts
to,
Magazine?
Welcome to Pop World. It's me and Simon Amstel just slagging people.
That was hilarious back in the day, him and Makita Oliver.
Oh, he was brilliant.
Pop World, that was brilliant.
Oh, yeah, I love Simon Amstel.
And then never mind the Buzzcocks. That was great, wasn't it? For like a couple of years, there was a period where that was brilliant.
Yeah, I still think I do stand up in a panel show. Like, I write material and I could go on a panel show because that's just what I was raised on.
Would you say we could give you your own TV show, like right now, and apply to your strengths of what you want to do? What TV show do you have?
Like one that exists or?
No.
I would definitely do a panel show.
Right.
Like maybe a quiz.
Would you host it or would you want to be a captain?
I would want to be a captain.
Right.
Or just on it.
What would the theme be? Politics?
Nah, because that gets boring. Almost like Mock the Week, but different. Do you know what I mean? Just what's happening in the news. I like that.
Mock the Month.
See, there's the way news moves now, but like Mock of the Day. News moves so
That's the thing with jokes as well. Like, you literally, because of the internet now and Twitter, if you, unless you have a joke, like if you've got a joke about, well, something like a political thing, it has to be on the day. Like, if you had a joke about all the parties at Downing Street during COVID,
that's done.
It's done.
That's done now. And it's almost the way you have to do stand up online now is like, if you write a topical joke, get that out that week.
Yeah.
And put that online if it works.
Yeah.
And then drop
it
because it's fucking done. And even, it'll, when you go see a gig and someone's like, Matt Hancock's a shagger. And you're like, doesn't matter anymore. Like, it gets lost so quickly.
Yeah, he still is.
Yeah.
But the joke does, yeah.
Yeah. He's weird. He's lent into it now and it's weird. He's showing up on TV shows with like fucking three buttons undone. So I'm like,
I thought you meant he has like a Durex collab. Oh, Matt Hancock. Have you seen Jerry Owens' math? Don't know why Zippy from him.
out of my ankle.
I haven't seen Rainbow. I'm just being annoyed. I just went, blah, blah, blah. Like, what the fuck is
I haven't
that?
Seen it either. I don't know how Chippy really talks.
He like that. On my ankle.
You sound like a cockney Dalek.
Hello, doctor.
I was trying to do... To then do like a line that dialects would do in a Cockney accent after you said that, and then realised I've never seen Doctor Who. I have no references.
I've seen clips of it. I know they go, "Hello, said- Doctor." That's all I have.
That's, we've got no references just other than saying hello in the character's name.
The Doctor will see you now.
What about whenever, like, someone asks you if you've seen something or you know of something, and you just say yeah because you want the conversation to go quicker, and then they start asking you about it, and you, the time to say, I actually haven't seen it, is gone? You know, like, you, when you
see,
were...
See, I just said, I'd be like, actually, I just lied to you.
Yeah, yeah, in the playground.
Yeah.
Did you see a film last night? Yeah. What did you like about it?
I lied. I'm not even listening to it. You've seen me do that loads of times. Yeah. You'll be, like, saying something, I'll just turn around and be like, I wasn't listening for like 3 minutes, sir, and you've just been talking to me.
In the playground, you could have shut down a lot of conversation by saying the phrase, I've seen it all. There used to be something on TV the night before.
Fucking Jake Bogg over
and
here.
People would go, that's great reference. People would go, did you see that film?
Yeah.
It was on TV last night. You go, yeah. You go, did you see the bit where? And then they'd explain the bit and you go, yeah. Did you see the bit where? See if you just had I saw all of it.
Yeah.
I saw it from start to finish, so I've seen all of it. Yeah. That would have shut down so many conversations. I miss going to school. I would like to go back.
Well, at this day and age?
Yeah. Because you'd clean up in terms of...
Hello, academia. Miss! I'm back! It's me, Zippy!
And I'm Australian!
Wait, Zippy, Todd? I'm still a lonely child.
Can you do... That's how you'll know I've had like a full showbiz breakdown. If I show up back again at Strandtown Primary School and an Australian accent, say,
hello, I'm a lonely child.
People with short ties will die soon. Really, he's fucking lost it.
Do you know how I once mugged myself so hard in school?
Yeah.
Are you familiar with Tamagotchis?
They were like, I was about 8 or 9, but I'm familiar with them, yeah.
So, for anyone who doesn't know, they were like pocket-sized electronic pets. So, a wee beep would go off and you'd feed your wee pet and you could pick the name of it and all that sort of thing. Or it needed to go to the toilet. People were obsessed. Like, kids were obsessed, myself included. Everybody had one.
And that's why I hate now I'm an adult. Like, people our age are like, can you believe kids are always on their phone? And you're like, we were obsessed with the shittest.
We just didn't have the technology.
Yeah, we were obsessed with fucking Snake, which back is in my day, getting bigger.
Back in my day, it was a cup and ball. Trying to catch the... We'd be on that for hours, you know?
Waiting for your parents to come back from holiday.
They've been away for 6 years. But no, me and my mum and dad just play World Traveller. You know World Traveller, where they would... they set off first. And then you've got to like... you got to find them somewhere in the world, you know, as a child. And the look on their faces... when I showed up in Botswana, you'd have thought they were raging, but new aliases and all weird. Tamagotchis, right? Our school was like, no more, you can't have a Tamagotchi in the classroom. All the beeping's going off, everyone's distracted. And it was P6, I think, and everyone's like, there was a note home about it. And then the next day, we're all sitting in class. No one's brought their Tamagotchi. All of a sudden, beep, beep. Everyone's like, oh, shit. The teacher's like, mm-hmm. Did I hear anything there? Moved on. Seconds later, beep, beep. Everyone's like, oh, shit. Someone's in trouble here. And I remember someone being like, is that you? And I said, no, is it you? I was like, miss, I think, whoever it is, I was like, I think Rachel here might have a Tamagotchi. I touted on the person and everyone's like, Rachel has a Tamagotchi, and she's like, it's you. And I was like, I know I don't have one. So I like drew the teacher's attention to someone sitting beside me.
Yeah.
And she had to empty her pockets, no Tamagotchi. Beep, beep. She goes, check his pockets. I went, I hardly have one. If I said you had one, took a Tamagotchi out of my pocket. I'd forgotten to take it out that morning. So I got in so much trouble because I had accused someone of having a Tamagotchi.
You were double bluffing.
That sums me up at school for sure.
Yeah, that sums you up. You would do that now.
Yeah, like, yeah, yeah.
That's such a you.
If I thought you, if you had a Tamagotchi, I'd phone the PSNI.
Yeah. And they'll be like, it's not 1998. So
I reported 58 people during the hosepipe ban. Because you got a tenner for everyone you got. What's been the best era of stand-up since you've been doing it? Like, the time where you were like, as a scene and all, this is brilliant.
Now? Oh, you fucking kidding me? It's great. I'm almost afraid of when the bubble's going to fucking burst. Like, because things are going so well. I'm like, is this just now what it is? Or, like, is there going to be a downward thing? Do you know what I mean?
I don't know. It has gone up and down in the past. And I think part of it is because travel is more difficult, although it's coming back. People stopped waiting for the big comedians from TV to come over and do the likes of the SSE.
Yeah.
They were like, well, let's see what's on the doorstep.
Yeah.
And that already had been happening, but then that extensiated that. But is that a word?
Yeah. But it's now like, extension, yeah, it is, yeah. But it's now like, people now know kind of who we are a bit more. Lockdown helped us.
Yeah, oh yeah.
In a way that we never thought it would.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Whereas now we go, like, people go abroad and know who we are and we'll tell other people who aren't from here about us. And that's fucking weird. Like, I went to Manchester.
Where do you think they're having a conversation about you right now? United Arab Emirates? There's anyone talking? Do you think anyone has talked about you in the last week in Kuwait?
I fucking hope not. Dirty Kuwaitan bastards.
What have you got against Kuwait?
I don't even know where it is. I just thought wherever you picked, I was like, I'm going to be racist.
It's definitely in the Middle East. I'm reading a book at the minute about geography and superpowers. It's good. As in, like, not like the part of being invisible, but like...
I'm from France and I can fly.
Très bien. But yeah, I like it at the minute. I think it's going good. Whenever we recorded this, you were gigging last night in Labrys.
Yeah. Oh, good? Yeah. The first half, right, like, it was the first half I got the best audience exchange in my life, right? Because I'm doing a bit at the minute where I talk about being Protestant, right? Shocker. And I talk about the Orange Order, and I say, for an organization that loves walking, a lot of fat bastards in it.
Nice.
For some reason. Nice. Right?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? They're like, oh, I walked 80 miles this week. They're like, why are you 5'4" and 30 stone, man? And then someone went, oh, you can talk, you fat fuck. Right? Which annoyed me because I do that. I make fun of myself for being fat. I'm like, you've kind of stamped on my punchline a bit there. Yeah. But I was like, no worries. Who said that, you fucking ugly cunt? And he was like, oh, my name's fucking whatever. I'm from Ards. And I went, and what do you do, mate? And he goes, I'm a mental health worker. And he says, you got mental health support, you fat cunt.
Maybe his job though is to encourage more mental health problems for mental health workers. He just prods a bear with a stick.
Yeah.
Literally prods.
Yeah.
I love that.
Oh, it was fucking brilliant. I was one of those, like, after I was rehearsing, being nervous for the audition and doing, and like I was like, you know, pretending like to be, and someone came up to me after and just patted me back and went, you look all right, man.
I'm a mental health, basically, mate. I'm all about getting people on the straight and narrow, making them realise that they might have problems, but you might not have a problem tomorrow, and there's always a brighter future. You wee disabled bastard. You know what I mean? Like,
mate, you just need to have a positive outlook on things, you fuck cunt. You know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? Pick those tits up and start again. Sun will come out tomorrow, and you can have a fry in the morning, you fucking chubby bitch. I was like, that's going in my set. That is like the most beautiful exchange ever. I loved it.
Love that. It's funny, whenever you ask people what their job is, I feel like for the last, especially because I emceed Labrys and Wednesday there, and I just love to have fun with the crowd, and you get to know people, you know, what do you do, what's your name? It feels like to me, the last 50 people I've asked have all had like an interesting job that you can do something with. Because even if it's a boring job, or they're like, yeah, it's boring as shit, that's damn funny in itself. You know what I mean? And then when someone's like, actually do something mad.
Yeah.
That's as good.
Every time I've spoken to someone, it's been engineer.
There's a lot of engineers floating about.
And they're the most boring fuckers ever. I'm like, do you want to engineer a way to make yourself fucking interesting? You're killing me here. Yeah. What's been your favorite exchange when you went, what's your job? Because I know it's a very, like, not hang, it's a standard MC thing to do.
Yeah, in London there, a couple of weeks ago, I asked a guy what he did in the front row, and he said he invests in video games. So as soon as he says that, I'm like, we have a couple of minutes here.
Yeah.
He was called Archie, and it was a lot of fun. And then Archie's girlfriend or partner, whose name I didn't unfortunately get, said, I was like, blah, blah, talking about Archie to her. And she said, she's from French. And I said, are you from France? I was like, how do you know about me? Because he was from England. And then she said, we flew over from Paris to see your SSE show. And I started sweating in my back. I was like, that is so unbelievable, yet
that
makes
weird.
Me like terrified. You know what I mean?
I understand what you mean. The other day I missed a flight.
By the way, I think there'd be performers who'd listen to that and go, fucking right, you did.
Yeah. But I understand that fear, because I nearly missed the flight. I was running through Manchester airport, right? And as soon as I was on the plane, I got a YouTube comment being like, oh, so you're running through the airport there, mate? I'm like, I'm still, what the fuck?
Yeah.
That's scary.
It is weird. I saw, like, me and Dave were going to London. I saw a guy take a photo of me as I walked onto the plane.
Yeah.
And part of me was like,
do you ask?
Like, weird, but weirdly raging. Like, not raging. I was like, fuck's sake. Like, what's the point? Like, that's so weird. And then I got over it very quickly and was like, if I saw someone that I like recognized get on a plane, I think I'd be more solid. For example, if fucking Duncan from Blue got on a plane going from Belfast to Edinburgh and I was sat there, I'd take a photo for the WhatsApp group.
Duncan from Blue.
100% I'd take a photo from the WhatsApp group. I'd love that.
Yeah, but you wouldn't ask him for a photo? See, I'm not, when I meet
I'm
someone,
I'm not a
I
photo
like,
asker, really.
I have done. I like your work, or like, I'm a big fan. Thank you. I don't ask for photos.
Yeah.
See what I mean?
I do that too. I'd be like, here, just want to say big fan.
Yeah.
But I also get the sense that whoever you said it to couldn't give a fuck.
No. You know? But like, I'm like, I'd need to say something.
Yeah.
But yeah, it is weird.
I was going to the States and saw Arnold Schwarzenegger in the airport going through like a scanner type thing. And I was like, oh, I can't, obviously, like, going through the customs thing, I can't get a photo. But I just, I went, Arnold, gave him a thumbs up. He just ignored me.
Yeah.
That was
beyond even respond. Like, he's allowed to. I remember someone saying they're working backstage in the SSE, and Elton John would get wheeled about in a wheelchair. And I'm like, he's earned that, right?
What do you mean? Like, he'd hurt himself?
No, he just didn't want to walk. Someone had to wheel him about because he was like, take me over there.
What's weird about that? I did that at the SSE shows.
Yeah, and you threw me off it too, to get it.
Do you see yourself going like full, like, would you like go full like DLA? Like, would you get like, would you like to get the scooter and all that? Like, just, and like, get like top of the range type job?
No, because I don't need type job. No, I don't need it. Do you know what I mean? Right. I could probably, like, you know what I mean? I'm not stubborn that I wouldn't ever do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I think I'm about a year away from that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
From refusing to walk anywhere.
I thought you were like, until you lose your legs or something. I was like, oh, I've got a year of legs left.
Weird way to describe your health.
Yeah.
I've got a year of legs left.
Yeah,
I think.
I'm not renewing them. I'm done with legs.
What other, like, what interactions do you get? Like, what's a typical interaction for you?
It depends whose show it is. One of your shows, it's normally, you know, someone's very, very polite. A bit posher than what I'm used to or something like that, you know. And then if it's one of mine and Patty's shows, it borders between horrible insults to me and
someone
gets
you in a headlock.
Someone grabs me by the dick and goes, Shaman, you wee spastic. That's normally what happens to me.
And that's just Patty welcoming you to the show.
Generally on stage, he went, the wee spastic isn't with me here tonight, and everyone cheered, and I'm in the back of the room like, you fucking, I'm the only one in this room with a full set of teeth. Go fuck yourselves.
But, like, his gout's so bad. Like, you're faster than Paddy.
I know. That's because he always makes fun of my disabled football team. And I was like, you didn't play that game. You'd have got fucking smoked, Patrick.
Yeah. What, like, What do you get, like, weird because of your, like, the podcast from Mudblood Podcast? Yeah. Like, do you get any weird DMs? Do you get sent videos? What's the last weird video you got sent?
Not a weird video. I got a message, and I was hungover in the airport, right? I was feeling like I had a green tea, just trying to be healthy, and a bag of Doritos because I've been trying that hard. And I was like feeling so gross about myself, and I just got a wee message. It went, "See if you get me free tickets to the show, you can ride me up the arse." And then I looked at her profile and was like, she can pay for those. But like I get sent filth. Filth I get sent. Like, horrendous like that.
Hey, what else, mate?
Daddies and
daddies. But like, right enough, like, just unsolicited?
I will. It's not that. I'll be standing beside like someone and I'll just open up my phone. Someone's just fingering themselves and I'm like, I didn't ask for this.
And
I did not.
And that's just being sent to you, like.
Like, yeah. Just sent to me, just being like, I'm just at this. I'm like, cool.
Get sent pictures. Some guy will be like, mate, I'm a Kildare village. There's a Pashmina on sale here you'd like.
I get sent any disabled person ever doing anything. That's you. That's you, wee man. Hey, here's me fingering myself. By the way, that's you climbing stairs. Like, that's the dichotomy of man in my fucking DMs, man.
You want any cocks dropping in?
No.
DMs? No.
No. No. You say that. Have you got loads?
No.
No. Anytime I'm in a gay bar, you get brought up. Not like you've been there, but like, oh, you get
brought up. There's just like smoke and they're all you just see my coat. I fly in.
She and Todd was just here, where to go. We sprinted off when you came in.
What do you mean I get brought up?
If I'm like, oh, you do comedy, yeah. Oh, Shane Todd, I love him. Like, you're begging. He fucking loves us. Look at him to get right in his face. You are begging the gay scene anytime.
Yes.
And I do frequent gay bars.
Yeah,
I love them.
But I'll tell you who'd be more popular than me. Dave.
I'm telling you. Like,
Dave Elliott on the gay scene.
Yeah.
Woo! We, after the gig in London, we went to like what was described to me as a gay arts bar, which are two great things,
gay
right?
Gay arts bar?
We went to a gay arts bar, and it was like there was a lot of like actors, you know. It was like very like lovey type setup.
Yeah,
I was ignored. I was gonna say I was tossed to the side, but
I don't know why that tickled me so much.
But me too, tickled me. But Dave gets serious attention. They love him, like. They love him.
Really?
Yeah, because what he'll do is, if he goes into a gay bar, he just takes his shirt off, spreads a bit of honey on his chest hair, and just says, have at it, beast.
The queen is here. That's the thing. Like, I always, if I'm going on a date or anything, I always go to, like, gay bars and stuff.
Yeah.
Because the vibes are good.
Yeah.
Although I tried to get in the one Manchester and was told I looked, they were like, no, this is a gay bar, mate. And I was like, are you saying I don't look gay enough? Fuck you, sir.
Oh, yeah?
Wouldn't let me in. Do you know what I mean? I'm like, I'll fuck a dude in front of you. Just let me in. I could hear.
Yeah, that'd be a weird door policy.
I could hear Always On My Mind by the Pet Shop Boys playing. I was like,
So you're telling me, you were outside, and if you close your eyes, all you heard, you're always on my mind.
Yeah.
Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I should have. Like, so it was like that?
Yeah. Can you sing a sectarian song, but in that voice? Sure, it's how.
Can I, Dan?
Is that your dad? My lady, daddy.
Daddy,
Uncle Mervyn wants me to say fuck a pope. Shit, I'd have a tenor for this.
What do you want me to sing? Like, not one of the real Bob?
No, no, just Penny Arcade.
Oh, I don't know it.
Do y'all know it? The step up and play. Can you do the sash? That's not really that bad. No, no, you're not getting cancelled for that.
No, honestly, I don't know it.
Oh, fuck, I don't know. What do you know?
It was on the 12th. It was beautiful. It was the sash my father wore, or it's the sash my father wore?
Oh, no. I love to wear the sash my father wore.
Right, see, I don't even.
Yeah, don't know it at all.
The loyalist songs, are they?
We do remixes. I've been over this. We do remixes. We don't make our own.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
You'll take a sample and then...
We're like the Weird Al of sectarianism. We'll be like, we're listening to songs being like, can you work and kill the Pope in that? Can you?
Yeah. Whereas like the nationalist, the Republican scene's more grassroots. It's more...
There, yeah. Remember in 1700, the British did fucking something, whereas we're like
the it's more like yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. We're put a Clubland beat over it, and right. we're remixing like Cold Cold Heart. Do you know what I mean? It's like Cold Cold Heart, up the Queen. Like that's us.
Yeah,
that's what we do.
Yeah, should have Disco Wars. That'd be fun.
It's I didn't realize it a thing until me and Dave Elliott were talking about it. Like, well, he doesn't really like them as much, but on like where we're from, like things like Scooter and stuff is like just seen as that's great. Like everyone, it's shit, but we all love it.
Yeah,
and I can't explain why.
Scooter's fun. Scooter's music. Yeah,
same as UB40 for some reason.
Yeah,
massive. And
I mean, Scooter has to be in the right context. Like, I wouldn't sit down after a long day of work, put my feet up.
Yeah.
And go,
good morning!
Stick on Nessa there, you know what I mean?
What one's Nessa Shag? I know it, because I was going to say
one of the ones with a big beat and he shouts over, I don't know. what particular work of Scooter is that one? It's the one he's talking about existential, I don't know what that is.
You don't know what existentialism is?
Is it, I've heard of people having an existential crisis.
Yeah, that's where you start to like question your own existence and stuff.
I'm having that.
Start to be like, why are we here?
Yep,
I had that when I was like 14. I was being like, what is the purpose of life? Is there a God? I'm like, I don't give a fuck. I used to be like, I used to be such a dick when I was a teenager. Like, oh, you believe in God? You're a wanker. Like, fucking listen to Ricky Gervais. See, now I just started believing stuff with no evidence required.
I went through a bit of a phase of like enjoying a debate on that, and I didn't really know what I was talking about.
Yeah.
And you were like at a house party and you're like, why am I doing, I'm now those
you're,
people.
Your mates
like,
are trying worst. To finger girls. I'm being like, aye, but if you read Leviticus 24, right? Yeah. And like, no one invited me anywhere.
Leviticus 24 sounds like a gay who was at the gay arts club I was at. Leviticus.
Hey, that's his how you introduced that's himself. That's his grinder profile. Leviticus 24.
Leviticus.
Twink.
Mob Blood podcast going very well.
Yes.
And I just love the comment section of it.
Oh, it's...
Big fan.
It's always fucking...
Wild.
Great podcast. Willie's a fucking cunt. Hate him. Great podcast though, boys.
Mental health work.
What I've started to notice now though, anytime someone gives me shit, there's like a wee army of people being like, you fucking leave him alone. I like that.
Do you think, with what's happening in Ukraine and Russia at the minute, do you think if they were like, listen, oh man, I've got to go and fight in this war... You think you make good soldier?
But they wouldn't let me in. I will be watching from the gate as you all get tossed up, as all get sent off, and I'm going to be like, yeah, that's what the Russians all are the doing. All the gigs are mine now.
Hold on. You're saying the Russians are trying to sack Kiev by just going up to Ukrainian soldiers? Come here.
That's honestly not a million miles away from what Russia would do in World War II, but...
I don't understand the reference.
It was a very nasty
You wouldn't one. Get to go? Would you like to, or would you be raging? You
would you
to
like
go?
To go die in a war? No, it's the one time I'm like, thank fuck I'm disabled.
Yeah.
What? Oh my God.
You think I could get away with not going? You think I could be exempt?
What, with Crohn's?
No.
You in the trenches with any gluten-free pasta? You'd be in the trench, but it's dirty. I don't want to be here.
Drink from this water tankard. I'll give you some. Have you touched? Has your mouth touched it? No, thank you. No, thank you. Guys, it's very mucky in these trenches. Is there any way we could put down a sheet? Maybe some sort of plastic sheet? Can we take our shoes off? Can everyone take your shoes off, please?
Everybody, I would hear it. Everybody be quiet. The enemy's near. He'll just hear you. The Western town is a getting gay. You send my Mustang gas.
They're like, turn everything off, please, turn everything off. All lights, shh. And then I mean, just a couple of glow sticks. When I was
young, you'll be in the church, be like, no way, Russian soldiers will give you that, but like, you know, our soldiers, they don't wave as much.
Yeah. I don't know. I think if I join war, I think pretty quickly they'd give me, what do you call that when they go like, away you go.
Honorable discharge?
Honorable discharge. I get an honorable discharge.
Yeah.
I would get an honorable discharge within 3 days and I'd be like, I don't deserve this. And they're like, trust me, you're a hero. Away you go. You can put the feet up and stuff. Honestly, like.
I generally think that's why the war isn't skirmish. The idea of it's not skirmish. I'm like, I'm not getting conscripted. So fuck
yeah, you. Very few comedians would get conscripted.
Oh, aye. We would be like a dad's army. And if, see if you did, like, it'd be like Police Academy, that lineup. Me, Jordy, Bartlett, Kieran Bartlett, Dave, you. It would be like, who has written this fucking script? Robbie yeah. McShane, like, is that a machine gun?
There's a film in that. There's a film in this. Absolutely.
Everyone just playing themselves.
Yeah.
Just imagine that, just about, who do you think you are kidding?
I would look, I look good in all the gear though.
Yeah.
You know?
I look like I'm on gear though.
Yeah. Apparently the Nazis were on gear during the Second World
they
War.
They were.
Like Coke, like something similar to Coke.
It was, I read a book on this. It was something that was essentially a chemical cousin to methamphetamine. Pervitin, it was called. And it was largely attributed.
Is that not why your uncle's a MacGyver?
Pervitin on me. I could be calling it the wrong thing. I think that's what it's called. But that's largely what is attributed to why they moved so quickly throughout Europe within 1939.
Guys walking at 80 mile an hour.
I was like, oh, I'm tired. Take some fucking meth and you'll Jesus. Walk from Berlin to Paris in 2 weeks.
That's terrifying.
Yeah. So that was largely attributed to what... And Hitler was on all fucking sorts.
Was he a gearhead?
Hitler was fucking wiped stinking.
It's wiped.
He was fucking wiped.
Listen,
he was on coke. He was on morphine. See, I'm fucking Jewish now. No, we're going through, like, we're just going to make... See, Germans.
He was wiped? He was wiped? Wiped? Was he right enough? He was on
coke? I'm, like, because he had so many injuries, and it got worse after the assassination attempt, in the bunker, you know, when the thing exploded, he was then heavily medicated. So he was initially had some wartime injuries from the First World War.
You tell me Hitler was on spice?
I'm telling you, Hitler was like, yeah. He's essentially that dude at a house party where you're trying to have a good time. He's like, see, I'm fucking Jewish. Don't know why they're here. Don't even know why they're in. And you're like, you fuck up, Adolf. I'm trying to fucking enjoy some scooter. Hitler, honestly, look into it, he was a heavy drug user. Who else was it? It was either Hess or Himmler. Was a massive, massive cokehead, morphine addict, big on the opioids. A lot of
these boys were partying.
Yeah, they were literally like in a bunker for a week all together and be like, bro, break out the fucking opium. A lot of the Nazi regime were big in the drugs. I sound like Paddy McDonald here.
Is there
all Nazis are drug dealers?
Is there Himmler? Goebbels lived in Turf Lodge for 3 months during the Second World War.
And he'll say that, and you go, did he? I mean, of course he did.
Is there a drug you haven't taken that you'd like to take? Any drugs you're curious about?
We talked about this on our podcast. Like, can I say it on this?
Dan?
Are we allowed to? I know your listeners are a wee bit different. Probably heroin, but more if I started doing it.
We don't endorse drug taking.
Yeah. We don't endorse it.
But probably...
Use code tea with me for 20%.
Yeah, mushroom tea with me with William Thompson, me being like, I tried this week.
That'd be fun.
Me and Andrew Ryan were talking about this. He was like, heroin must be class if you're willing to lie on your own shit. And that's why I you're like, I kind of want to see what that's like, but also I would never touch it. Do you know what right. I mean?
I've seen. But if we did a Patreon series exclusive called Willie Tries Gear.
I fucking do.
You did?
I did, 100%, yeah.
That'd be a lot of fun. I like the way you're like, your listeners are a bit different. Like, listen, some of these guys there's a few guys here popped a few more Baraka than they recommend the daily allowance, let me tell you.
But I'm dead weird. Like, I'll be like, I'll try anything, but won't take painkillers. Well, not taking.
Yeah, that is weird.
I'm terrified I'll become a... It's because I grew up watching wrestling.
Right.
And saw, like, so many wrestlers become addicted.
Yeah, but they're probably taking, like, the highest strength stuff. Yeah, if you pop a paracetamol, yeah. Like, you'll be okay.
I don't know where that will lead me. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Imagine it just got rid of your cerebral palsy. You took one paracetamol.
That's why I take cat. Did used to be treated to cerebral palsy. Look that up, not making that up. It did.
You used to be treated to cerebral palsy?
No. It used to be used to treat spasticity in muscles. That's where the phrase comes from, Shane. That's the actual term, you fucking child. That's where the term spasticity comes from, spasticity in muscles. It used to be given to people, ketamine.
Right.
Because, like, if I...
Maybe he's born with it. Maybe it's ketamine. I'm laughing.
I feel like a new woman.
What have you got coming up?
We have the Live My Blood podcast on the 19th of March in Glasgow. And I'll be announcing my Limelight 2 show on the 9th of July this week.
You'll be announcing it?
Yeah. So it's not out yet, but I'm kind of announcing it now. But tickets, I have to send the stuff off, but I'll probably be
out. What's it going
to
be called?
Barely Noticeable. Because of that one review I got that said I have a barely noticeable cerebral palsy. And I let that go.
Is that why... What were you doing with the wrestling mask?
It was there.
Oh, right,
okay. It was to get us, like, look at that. And I was like, see, if I take my shirt off, I look like I wrestle in Butlins.
I thought that was for a new show.
Nah, I just did it.
You look like you wrestle in Butlins?
I look like I wrestle in Butlins.
Yeah.
Like, Conswater Community Centre has a thing look like on, you're and
the,
I'm there.
You're the Intercontinental Champion of Butlins.
Castle Rey Mysterio, that's me.
Conswater used to be the spot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They started following me on Instagram.
Conswater?
Conswater.
Oh, shit, bro.
Yeah, fucking... Free pick. You want a Pickwick's? You come see fucking Willie T.
Pickwick's still going?
Nah, it's gone. But no, I mean, I can get you sorted.
I love that big follow from Conswater. You're like, oh, why?
I also got approached to do a gig in Victoria Square. I'm getting all the weirdest bookings at the minute.
I think a lot of people got sounded out about that, so I don't know whether they're like, they're going to run it.
Yeah.
Or they're looking someone to organize it.
I just
went up in the dome.
Yeah, I just went, here's a fee. And if, you know.
27 grand.
Yeah. No, not him. I sent them whatever 26. It was, and they were like, oh, we'll see. And I'm like, I know you have it.
Who's the weirdest social media follower you've ever got?
The weirdest? I don't know. The one maybe I was most buzzing about was I got off Paul Smith, the Liverpool guy.
Yeah.
Okay. I got off him, which he follows everyone. It's not that big a deal, but I was buzzing off that. The weirdest? A guy who wrestles for NXT. Which is like
WWE's rival?
No, it's development brand.
Oh, right.
It's still on TV and stuff, but it's like where you go before you go onto the main roster. Someone wrestles for them, which was a nice...
Have you exchanged any DMs with him?
No, he's just there.
You should message him and be like, listen, mate, a couple of tickets for Mud Blood Live. What would you be willing to send me for it? See what happens.
It's like, train me to wrestle. I'd love to do a vlog where we, like, comedians learn to wrestle. That would be so
I would
fun.
Be well off that as long as nobody touched me.
Oh, yeah. It hurts.
I'd have to do mine via green screen because I'm not willing to be like hurt by anyone or touched.
Yeah, you would be like Tyler Breeze. I know you don't know who that is, but it's his gimmick. His whole thing is like, I'm so pretty.
Yeah,
that would be your.
It's not really a gimmick.
Yeah, it's a way of life, bro.
It's just nature, isn't it?
Just nature.
It's just nature, mate. That's all it is.
So I embrace. I'm an ugly wee cunt. It's great.
You're not. Don't be saying that. No, I did earlier tell you look like a pillow. But
yeah.
A medication.
When I get him taking my headshots yesterday, he was like, see, straight on, adorable. Turn my face to the side, 45. The side of my face is so gross, and then I look straight on, adorable.
You've got, like, from the side, and my side profile isn't actually that good. I mean, it's good, but, like, for what I'm, like, front on, it's not that good. But, like, from side on, like, your your nose does turn up a wee bit.
Like a wee, really up like that, yeah.
Like a wee pig.
Yeah.
Nose. But everything else is
so you were being so careful.
No, like you're actually like, turn quite to the side again.
Fat bitch.
No, you're not fat at all. You're not. Turn to the side. Your eyes and everything looks good from the side.
Yeah.
But yeah, like it's like
it's
snout.
The wee nose, but straight on, it's like that's actually a cute wee nose.
Yeah.
It's horrible.
What do you think? What do you, my side profile be on? My chin actually is a wee bit quite bulbous.
I'll sound like a Nazi if I tell you what you look like from the side. You've got like a jawline, you know, you have a strong jawline shift from the side. And what is this podcast?
My eyes are my worst feature. I hate
really?
Yeah.
See, they're my bit. Like, see these brows, bitch.
Oh, yeah.
And people are like, you get them done. I don't. This is what God
gave
me.
You do get them done.
I don't. I swear on my fucking life, you can go through any photo of any period of my life.
At least you're not being defensive.
This
about
is
it.
What I look like. No, Ronnie,
I swear to
this,
fuck.
This was
mate,
an R.
I'll cut my dick off. That's how serious I am that I've never had my eyebrows.
Do you know why? This was an hour-long thing in our podcast the other week of Paddy being like, yeah, get them fucking done. I'm like, no, I don't. See, like, go through.
You have beautiful eyebrows. My eyebrows are shit. I've said it in the podcast.
Girls get jealous of my eyebrows.
Yeah.
Like, not even like they're now. They're like, you fucker, how do you have them?
But then that's balanced out.
Yeah. By.
By your snout.
Yeah. You're insulting me like Dr. Seuss.
The Lord giveth.
The Lord taketh away.
I like the way you were like balanced up with the cerebral palsy. I'm like, no, the nose.
The nose, yeah. Here's a new insecurity. You
I think the nose is above the cerebral palsy.
Really? It's that bad? I like it. It's like a wee
no,
cute.
No, I don't think it's that bad.
I'm like one of the Who's in the Grinch. I'm sitting there going, that Grinch is a wee cunt, isn't he?
I think if you wanted a holiday, I think you'd kill two birds with one stone by going to Turkey. I could get my eyes done, you get your nose done.
I'm happy with my nose. Stop. Stop trying to change.
Patreon vlog. Turkey with Willie T.
I would get the teeth done if I went to Turkey, get them pure. Like, do you want someone gets them too white?
You would go top level white?
Yeah, yeah. Someone gets them too much and they're smiling and you're like, fuck, right, that's not natural, you freak. That's where I go.
Yeah.
Yeah. But my nose is something like always got me a fun of for it too.
Oh, I feel bad.
There is nothing about my appearance that bothers me. It's funny.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? I'm not one of these people like, I'm fucking gorgeous. Like, fully aware of what I look
like. I like the way back in the day you were like, oh, you're being like, you know, made fun of because that. And you were just like, I know, but look at these. Yeah. The police were like, no, I do have to say, mate, your eyebrows are fucking
fur, you get beautiful. Them done. Fur fucking plenty of bro.
Really good.
Yeah.
Really good.
Like, I got bullied so much when I was younger. Like, I'm so immune to it now.
Oh, Christ.
No, but it's not, do you know what I mean? It just is what it is. But, like, I'm so immune to it now. So it's good when someone heckles you or something, and you're like, doesn't even
feel. I got bullied too, but mainly at home.
That's really sad.
No, I got bullied at school too.
Yeah, yeah. What did you get bullied for? Trauma.
If
trauma
I'm honest,
circle.
I think being so talented.
Just your general personality.
Just for being me. Just being me. I
believe that.
It's hard to know exactly why, but I think if it's possible, I always tried too hard.
Yeah.
Like, to make friends and, like, I don't know.
I probably got a bit of that too. Like, I don't get they got me for everything, but that, you know, that part's on me. There's sometimes I look back and when I got bullied and I'm like, I deserve that. Like, I used to go about in, like, primary school rolling the like, when I, if someone was, like, being nasty to me, I'd start doing, rolling my eyes back ahead and going, like the Undertaker.
It's weird you were bullied.
Probably deserved it then. Yeah. Because I'm sitting in the middle of the playground going,
I remember doing like a very similar thing, like The Rock. I remember this guy like taking the piss out of me.
Yeah.
And he like went on to become a friend. But I remember like getting so annoyed that I took my wee watch off, put my hands on my knees and did The Rock thing, went like this. Right? I beckoned him forward like this. And here's the thing. He came forward and he beat the shit out of me. And I'd invited it by literally going,
yeah.
Come and have a go if you think you're hard enough. And he was.
You don't look like The Rock. You look like a witch in a fairy tale. Eat the apple, young one.
Come into my cauldron, Mr. Snout.
And well, that's what this episode's called. Come to my cauldron, Mr. Snout. See, to be fair, anytime someone's like, because I was disabled, I always, people would try to hit me.
Yeah.
Normally did beat the shit out of them. I'm surprisingly resilient like that. Well, you've seen me fall.
You're physically
off
resilient.
Things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can take a hit, like, do you know what I mean?
I'm the opposite. Like, when Storm Eunice hit, I got a breeze come through one of the windows in the house and it knocked me down. Like.
Yeah. Well, the funny, like, I weirdly, like, I don't enjoy getting hit, but it gives you, like, a weird rush. I remember sometimes someone smacked me, expected me to go down, and
you popped the boner?
Honestly, borderline, the punch me, and I was like,
Do you like it?
Yeah. Genuinely, I.
Like,
there is a genuine rush I get.
Like, to what level? Like, say you're with a girl, right? You're having intercourse or whatever you want to call it. Whatever the young people today call it.
Yeah.
And she goes, listen, I could, like, I'd love to fucking throw a dig at your temple here.
I'm like, if you're going to do it, do it. Don't, none of this bitch shit. I want to feel it if you're going to do it.
But that doesn't make, like, get, like, that's not good. That's not, like, what about that makes you, what?
I don't know. It just works for me.
What if a girl's like, here, do you know what would be hot? Hold your eye open and let me flick into your eye.
No, right. That's not hot. That's nothing.
That's not hot. Like, I dig in the temple. Ooh.
Yeah.
But be flicked in the eye.
I don't know. There's probably a psychological issue behind that. Don't know what it is. But even if I'm in a fight with someone, I do get a genuine rush out of it. Not like I'm not digging someone, being like,
so much.
But like, I'm coming out of it like I'll be like really happy. And someone's like, the fuck's wrong with you? Like, I don't know. I really like it. I don't know what that is.
What if a girl goes here? You know those things
and
for
someone
like
gets their fucking
beating
nails.
Meat? You know those wood, bits of wood that we hammer with the spikes?
Yeah.
What if she goes, let me just fucking couple of taps on the forehead? In?
Right, this is just the Three Stooges now. Why I am? I'm like, fucking hell.
What if a girl's like,
Did you ever take none?
What if a girl's like, let me peg you and then stop, but I want you to walk over and stand that rake as I'm doing it?
What Looney Tunes fucking riding is this? Put up my doll's chandelier, I'll stick a dildo up yours and it falls down. The Fuckle Brothers?
The Fuckle Brothers?
Fuckle Vision! Here, we have to paint this living room and put these nipple clamps on the box. They're the only painting, decorating, cock and ball torture bras about.
I can't wait until the next time you're having sex, and I like to think the girl's going to be a tea with, she's going to be a tea with me fan and just like fucking drop an elbow to your head and spark you out and go, you send a podcast, you like that?
Go drop a bucket of paint on my head and... To me, to you.
Got to give you a wank, put one of the electric buzzers in her hand. I think we should leave it there because I could ask you way more detailed questions.
Yeah, well, we'll have another one coming up and there's a guest on with us I think would be very interested.
Live in with Mickey, yeah, Barlow?
Am I not here?
Oh, you're doing the live stream, but that'll have happened in the past, though this is the present and it will be in the future. But it will be in the past.
Yeah. Well, they can go back on it, can't they?
Yep.
Yeah, well, yeah, follow up for more details about my fucking sex life. There you go. I'm never getting the ride again, ever.
You will.
Oh, I will.
You will. Put the blue badge on, you sweet.
I can park anywhere.
Guys, thank you. Your face got really intense when you did that. It was weird. Guys, thank you very much to my guest, William Thompson.
Thank you.
As always, great comedian. Go see him live. You got any live dates coming up?
9th of July, Limelight 2. William Thompson, barely noticeable.
Links in the description. Dan says, I am touring America. The tickets are... Take the wee link, keep this in. There's a link tree link. So take that and put it in because I'm doing a tour of America in March. And then I've got a tour. All tickets are on shine.net/comedy to tour Northern Ireland. I'll be hopefully adding UK dates, Ireland dates, maybe a couple in Europe. People are asking me about Toronto. I'll hopefully learn near to a Toronto show. Anyway, thank you very much for watching and listening. We appreciate it. Patreon.com/TeaWithMePodcast. Thank you, my guest, Willie T. What if a girl was like, let me just once put both of my fingers as far as I can into your ear, bring you forward for a headbutt to the nose?
I'd kill her. Not like from the headbutt of a very
Oh, because you have
head.
Such a strong head?
Yeah.
But it might push your nose down.
It might fix it, yeah.
Thank you.